Hello, friends. Welcome to Coffee and Conversation. A ray of hope coming from the Gordon Avenue Baptist Church in Adel, Georgia. Friend, let me invite you today to take your Bibles and turn with me over to the book of Proverbs. We'll be in Proverbs chapter 13. I want us to look at verse number 10 today as our text verse of Scripture. Get a cup of coffee. Some other type of beverage if you don't drink coffee. Let's sit together, have an encounter with God and His precious Word on this beautiful day. Well, goodness. Good way to get a new day started, a fresh cup of hot coffee and a word from God's precious book, the Bible. Friend, over in the book of Proverbs, chapter 13, verse number 10, the Bible says here, only by pride cometh contention, but with well-advised is wisdom. Another version says, through insolence or rudeness comes nothing but strife, but wisdom is with those who receive counsel. That word contention means arguments. Only by pride comes arguments, but the well-advised is wisdom. Today, friend, I want to bring to you a devotion I've titled, Having Humility. You know, when you think of humble people, what image comes to your mind? What characteristics and attitudes contribute to having a humble spirit? We often hold misconceptions about humility. Some people believe they can gain humility only when they deny the talents they possess. That's not humility. Friends, that's foolishness. When we deny our abilities, we deny the goodness and the grace of God, who is the giver of every good and perfect gift. Humility comes from a proper perspective about our God-given gifts and talents. You see, we can admit that we have talents, abilities, and intelligence, and still remain humble as long as we acknowledge we received all of these gifts from God. Therefore, we don't take the glory, but instead we give thanks to God, who is the source of our talents and abilities. We give Him the glory. We also thank Him for our accomplishments. My friend, we shouldn't say, I can't brag about the talents I've received, but just look at what I've done with them. Again, we acknowledge that God works through us and that without Him, we cannot do nothing. Foster humility in your life today. And thank God for giving you abilities and accomplishing His work in and through you. Give God glory. All the glory belongs to God as you use your gifts and your talents for Him today. Continue to have a spirit of humility. And friend, if you have the ability to do anything good, you can bet it is a gift from God. Think about these things. Let's pray. Father, it's so easy to have pride, but the Bible says again, pride comes before the fall. Help us never possess a spirit of pride and be so proud of what we can do within ourselves, but help us always remember and have a spirit of humility. And Lord, thank you for the things that we're able to do. And may your glory shine through us that others can see Christ. It's your glory. And let us always have an humble spirit about your glory. Thank you for loving us. And God, thank you for the message today that reminds us that we need to have a spirit of humility. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, friend, I do pray that you'll take to heart what's been said today and always be humble. I think about that old song that I can't remember who used to sing it. They used to sing, "Oh Lord, it's hard to be humble when you're perfect in every way." Well, friend, we're far from being perfect in every way. We need to have a spirit of humility and thanksgiving for the gifts that God has given. Use them for His glory, that others may see Christ. God bless you. Have a good day.